Topic is probability. This probability having wide application, not only in the field of business, but also we have lot of decision will be taken in our daily life. For that, we will be applying the concept of probability. Then what is mean by probability? Or how we can define the probability? We can define the probability in a simple manner as it is a chance of occurring an event. But according to the classical definition of probability of happening an event A is equal to number of cases favorable to an event A, the whole divided by total number of cases. This is the definition which is given under classical definition. For understanding the concept of probability in very detailed way, for that we should know some terms used in probability. That is the sample space. What is mean by sample space? Then what is the role of sample space in probability? Sample space, that means it is a total outcomes from an experiment. Total outcome, that means when we are tossing a coin, what are the outcomes we can expect? Head, comma, tail. When we are tossing two coins, then what are the total outcomes we can expect? Head, 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 tail, tail, head, tail, tail. When we are rolling a dice, what are the total outcomes we can expect? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the total outcomes we can expect when we are rolling a single dice. Similarly, when we are rolling two dice, then what are the outcomes we can expect? We have 36 possible outcomes we can expect when we are rolling two dice. So all those outcomes, total possible outcomes, can be represented as sample space, yes, of an experiment. Next, we can discuss about what is mean by mutually exclusive event. This is very important for solving many problems which is related to probability. Mutually exclusive event, that means if one event that prevents all other events are called mutually exclusive event. For example, when we tossing a coin, then the probability of getting head that prevents the probability of getting tail, and vice versa. This is the example for mutually exclusive event. Next, we can discuss about what is mean by dependent event. Dependent event, that means if one event that depends upon the subsequent events are called dependent event. Independent event. What is mean by independent event? If one event that does not depend upon the subsequent event, then such type of events are called independent events. Now next, let us discuss some examples in probability which is related to playing cards. In a playing cards, we have 52 cards are there with a four category. One is the section of spade, clover, heart and diamonds. In each category, there are 13 cards are there. The cards starting from as. As 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then three court cards, king, queen and jack. These are the number of 13 cards which are already available in each section. Similarly, we have total 52 cards are there. That is 13 into 4. Here, spade and clover, both sections are treated as black cards. Heart and diamonds, these two sections or categories are red cards. Next, we can solve some questions which is related to the playing cards in probability. In a well shuffled pack of 52 cards, what is the probability of taking a black card? Then, the favorable cases for taking a black card from a well shuffled pack of 52 cards are 26 cards. That is 26 divided by 52 is equal to 1 by 2. Similarly, taking a red card, that means here we have 26 red cards are there, 26 divided by 52, again 1 by 2. What is the probability of taking a court cards? We have 3 court cards in each category. Similarly, we have 4 categories are there. So that total court cards available in a pack of 52 cards are the, that is 3 into 4, that is equal to 12. 12 by 52 is the probability of taking a court cards from the well-shuffled pack of 52 cards. Then, when we are tossing a coin, then what is the probability of getting head? That is also equal to 1 by 2. When we are tossing a coin, the probability of getting tail, that is also equal to 1 by 2. So the total probability, when we tossing a coin, the total probability is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, that is equal to 1. Every time the total probability is equal to 1. That is one of the main characteristics of probability. Next, we will be discussing about the characteristics. What are the characteristics of probability? Here, the primary characteristics, that means it is very essential rule which consists of the probability. That means the probability which lies between 0 and 1. That can be represented in terms of mathematically as 0 less than or equal to p less than or equal to 1. If p equal to 0, that indicate impossible event. And p equal to 1, that indicate it is certain. And the total probability should be equal to 1. These are the main characteristics of probability.